The Alliance Alive is an RPG for the Nintendo 3DS developed by Furyu. At first glance, it looks like a sequel to Legend of Legacy, which was made by the same developer and most of the same staff, except for the scenario writer Kato Masato, who is famous for his work on Chrono Trigger and not so famous for his work on Chrono Cross. In Alliance Alive, he was replaced by Murayama Yoshitaka, who is better known for being the director of the Gensou Suikoden series. I mean, the good ones. The illustrator Kobayashi Tomomi is not working on this new game either. But to be honest, her absence doesn't make much of a difference, because she was only a secondary artist in Legend of Legacy, while the character designer and main illustrator in both Legend of Legacy and this new game was actually Hirao Ryo, who has a pretty charming art style. And as much as I love Tomomi's drawings, her art style doesn't match with the graphics in the game. Alliance Alive deals with a world where humans are enslaved by demons. Those demons use their magic to cover the planet with a black mist that blocked the sunlight. And now, humans don't even remember that the sky was once blue. Except for Ursula, a very carefree and naive little girl who believes in legends and fairy tales. Her father is the leader of the resistance against the demons, and she helps him in hopes to find the truth about the world. The story begins when Ursula drags her childhood friend Galil into exploring a forbidden area. But because of her selfishness and recklessness, she pays a heavy price. Galil blames himself for being unable to protect her, and promises that one day he will show her the real blue sky. However, this is only one side of the story. The plot in Alliance Alive is divided in many different groups. Each group has their own mini-campaigns, which introduces their backstories and motivations. And many times, those campaigns will intertwine with one another, giving you multiple points of views to the same events. Eventually, all those different groups will join together to form a powerful alliance with the same objectives: to make peace among all the races, to get rid of the black waves that surround and separate each of the continents, and of course, to reclaim the blue sky. This game uses a more balanced version of the turn-based battle system from Legend of Legacy, which have elements that are similar to the battle system in the Saga games. For example, you get many bonuses on attributes depending on what you do more often during battles, but this time you can only get more HP and SP, and you need to upgrade your special attacks individually by using them in battle over and over again. In order to get more defense and strength, you have to rely on better equipment. You also get talent points, which you can use to buy extra abilities. It's simple, it's fast, and it works. Now let's go back to Legend of Legacy for a little while. Legend of Legacy was announced as a spiritual successor to the Saga series. And since the game designer and illustrator worked on that series in the past, it was a very convincing statement. And that was not all. Many big promises just kept coming every week, which made it feel like Legend of Legacy would become a new classic. But in hindsight, all of those promises were just a bunch of bullcrap. And as expected, they didn't deliver any of those things. So it may be for the better that they are not trying to make any spiritual successor this time. It might be the writer's influence, but if I was to make a comparison between Alliance Alive and any other RPG, I would have to say it reminds me a lot of Suikoden. And that's because in this game you get something very similar to the 180 Stars of Destiny. I'm talking about the guild system, which allows you to recruit countless NPCs across the world to work for you in one of the guilds. You can assign different tasks to each new member, by sending them to one of the five divisions: Intelligence, Blacksmithing, Sorcery, Tactics, and Library. Each one of those will provide you with several support abilities during battles and exploration, and you can also expand and create new branches all over the world. Unlike Legend of Legacy, Alliance Alive was not promising much, but it delivered a lot. The story is way better, the battles are more balanced, there is almost no need for grinding, there is a bigger variety of environment types to explore, and when you reach around 30% of the main campaign, you actually get an open world with a fair amount of important tasks that you can complete in any order you want. And very often during important events, you will be presented with multiple options. Your choices will not change the main story, but they will have an effect in current events, and can change things like enemy difficulties, item rewards, and extra playable characters and guild members. There is also a limit break-like system where you sacrifice your weapon for massive damage, as well as many types of vehicles and secret events. The only thing that bothers me about this game is the complete lack of voice acting, but that's not necessarily a problem, as there are many people who don't even care about that. All in all, it's just great. I suppose 6,000 yen is a reasonable price for all of this. It takes around 40 hours just to finish the main campaign, but completionists might double the length of the playthroughs by looking for all the secret content hidden across the huge world map. Furyu has been trying to make big in the Japanese RPG industry for quite some time. But in my opinion, their games have always been flawed titles that are too ambitious for their own good. However, I think Furyu has finally paid for their sins by making Alliance Alive. If anything, this was a step forward in the right direction, at the very least. Regardless, I had a blast playing this game, and that's because it felt a lot like a classic JRPG from the SNES and the original PlayStation era, even more than games such as I Am Setsuna. As of now, there are no plans to localize this game in the West, but Alliance Alive sold quite well on its first weeks, so there is hope. And that's it for this review. But if you have more questions about Alliance Alive or any other Japanese game, just leave a comment. Thank you for watching. Bye!